An investor's overall asset allocation is one of the most important considerations when setting up and maintaining a portfolio. The ratio of asset classes like equities and fixed income will largely determine the overall risk level. But because individual investments and asset classes have their own investment performance patterns, the original asset allocation can drift away from your original ratios. Portfolio rebalancing is the process of bringing your portfolio's asset allocation back to your initial target allocation. Let's look at a simple example to start. Let's say we have a $100,000 portfolio with 70% equity and 30% fixed income. Over the next year, stocks have a relatively good year and earn 20%. And let's say our fixed income increases by 2%. Breaking this down, we have $70,000 in stocks that earn 20%, which is $14,000. That gives us a new total of $84,000. We take our $30,000 in fixed income and increase this by 2%, which is $600, giving us a new total of $30,600. Our new overall portfolio value is $84,000 plus $30,600, which equals $114,600. Overall, we've gained 14.6% for the year. But more importantly, our new asset allocation is calculated as follows. For our equities, we take $84,000 and divide by $114,600. This equals 73.3%. Our fixed income is $30,600 divided by $114,600, which equals 26.7%. Our new asset allocation breakdown for our portfolio has drifted away from the initial 70% equity, 30% fixed income. This portfolio is now slightly more aggressive. Because markets and asset classes tend to move in cycles, perhaps the next year equities lose 20% and fixed income might earn 3%. Let's see what our ending portfolio value would be after 2 years. For our equities, we take $84,000 and subtract 20%, which is $16,800, to give us $67,200. For our fixed income, we take $30,600 and add 3%, which is $918, to give us $31,518. Our new portfolio value is $98,718. But what if we had rebalanced our portfolio after that first year? Rebalancing would bring our asset allocation back to 70% equity and 30% fixed income. And we could do this by selling some equity and buying some fixed income. Our portfolio value at the end of 1 year was $114,600. 70% of $114,600 equals $80,220. Since we had $84,000, we would need to figure out how much equity to sell. We simply take what we have, $84,000, and subtract our target of $80,220, which gives us $3,780. So we sell $3,780 from our equities and use that to buy more fixed income. If we add $3,780 to our fixed income holdings of $30,600, we get $34,380. Now, let's see what our ending portfolio value is after year two. Remember, our equities lost 20% in year two, so we take $80,220 and subtract 20%, which is $16,044. Subtract this from $80,220 and we have $64,176. Our fixed income grew by 3% in year two, so we take $34,380 and add 3%, which is $1,031.40, for a fixed income total of $35,411.40. Adding these totals together, $64,176 plus $35,411.40, we get $99,587.40. So in this example, we can see a few reasons why portfolio rebalancing can make a lot of sense. One, it allows an investor to maintain an asset allocation at a level that is appropriate for their risk tolerance and preference. And two, it instills discipline into your portfolio management. In this case, we sold off some equities after a strong year. But in cases where equities have a poor year and provide a negative return, rebalancing would require us to add more money to our equity position. It can be difficult for some investors to add more money to an investment that has just experienced a loss, but by using a regular rebalancing period, such as once per year, portfolio rebalancing can help take out some of the emotions of investing.